От студиото на Bloomberg в Лондон мой гост е Том Бегли, който е филмов и театрален режисьор. Hi Tom, it's nice meeting you here at the Bloomberg studio. You filmed in Bulgaria. You were there also as a tourist, but let's start with the filming part first. Being a filmmaker, we know the country is now extremely popular with the big Hollywood productions, but for small filmmakers, small independent filmmakers from Europe, from your experience, what can you say? How was your experience filming there, and what else do you need from the country from now on to be done?
Well, for a start, I mean, I have to say, you know, Bulgaria is a beautiful place, especially during the summer. The one downfall that I would say was actually getting from one location to another. Now, this in particular applies to Sofia, the capital. I found that the roads, travelling by road there, was almost treacherous. When we filmed in Varna, which is the second biggest city, again, I found that the roads appear to be going the same way. The infrastructure doesn't seem to be as good as it should be, and more so, that was more apparent in the winter time as opposed to the summer. So I find that the summer and the sun kind of masks over quite a lot of infrastructure problems that that you guys have in Bulgaria. I have to say, you know, on the whole, it was okay, but it could be better. There could be a lot of improvements made. Now, you know, for a small company, a small production company, to go out there and spend maybe 50 or 100,000 pounds, you know, you want to be getting value for money. So, you know, I'd like to see some improvements, and I'd like to see some, you know, some initiatives to bring in smaller film companies as opposed to the big guys up in New Bayana.
The workforce there, I mean, how did you find people, crew, and in general, what's your opinion about the workforce over there?
The workforce, I mean, I can't fault them. I mean, the workforce are very good. They're very willing to help. You know, I mean, they'd almost work for no money, but that's not the point. You know, people do a job for you. You expect to be paid. I mean, I wouldn't want to do a job for no money. It's a kind of different in the UK. You know, it's probably more unionized in the UK and most definitely in America, where crew are part of a union. But I found that in Bulgaria, it's not quite the same. They're getting there, but it's quite a slow process. So, like I said, very helpful, but I think would probably need to tighten up on their ideas, you know, and move forward, you know.
Apart from the roads, why is Bulgaria attractive for filmmakers from Europe especially, or from Asia?
I suppose the main thing about Bulgaria is, I mean, from an outsider's point of view, is one that it does appear to be cheaper to film in Bulgaria, and you don't need as much licensing. Now, they're not as strict, you know, regarding the licensing laws for filming, you know, for closing roads, you know, whereas in the UK you need a license to shoot in a phone box, you need a license to put a camera on a road, you know, so it's quite stringent and quite strict, both in the UK and in the United States, whereas Bulgaria is not quite as strict. So, I mean, I would like to see, you know, I'd like to see, again, that kind of tightened up, if you like, you know, and a bit of money put into developing and to encourage, you know, companies like myself from the UK to do more, you know, to use the facilities, to use the country, to use the crew over there, you know.
In terms of equipment, can you find everything you need there, or you have to bring it from the UK?
Well, I think, you know, we've so far we've been quite lucky. We've found, you know, everything we've required over there, be it just a little bit slow in coming, but we have actually found the equipment that we've required over there. So yes, I mean, the equipment is, you know, is there, is available.
Okay, and as a tourist, you've been there as a tourist separately from your work.
I have indeed.
Why a person from the UK would go on a holiday over there? And if it's okay, most people say it's the price, but at the end of the day, you can get, you know, affordable packages everywhere around the world. Apart from the price, is there anything else that would attract you there, or is there anything else that you would like to, you know, actually mention that something needs to be done a little bit more? What should we do more in terms of tourism? And you know, no matter who comes into power now, what would he mind first?
Well, you know, going there as a tourist is quite enjoyable. Now, again, going there as a tourist in the summertime when it's nice and hot and there's people and the beaches are beautiful, it's a wee bit different than going there in the winter. I mean, wintertime is actually quite bleak over there, and you can actually see, you can see that it's it does need a facelift. Now, I spent quite a bit of time in Varna, and quite a number of the buildings, I have to say, do look quite dilapidated and antiquated. So it would be nice to see some investment put into refurbishing and making these places look quite nice, you know. Like I say, summer, I think, tends to mask over these issues. And also, again, I go back to the roads. I wish that you guys would sort out your roads. You know, it's not good, and they're not going to get better. They're only going to get worse.
Is that what you're advising people who are who you discuss with going over there and filming over there? What would be your advice to European filmmakers who haven't been there yet, but they're planning to have their huge production over there?
Well, my advice to filmmakers, one is to certainly prepare, you know, do your preparations, and collaborate, if you like, with somebody over there. Collaborate with some of the Bulgarian production companies. Get them involved.
Are they good enough? Are they?
Well, no. I mean, they're good. They're good, don't get me wrong. Now, we all have different ways of looking at this. I find that they are getting better, but the quality of some of the TV there is not quite up to scratch. I mean, some of the stuff I wouldn't really entertain. Actors-wise.
Can you use Bulgarian actors even more, or do you definitely need British actors when you go filming over there?
Well, I mean, I like to do collaboration. I like to do a mix and match, if you like, using British actors and Bulgarian actors. I mean, it's, you know, I'd like to get the ambience off the place. So, you know, I like to use the people, and in this case, the Bulgarian actors. The quality of the Bulgarian actors I found are superb. You know, these guys are really, really are excellent, you know, and their grasp on English is superb. And I've had the opportunity to use both Bulgarian and English, and you know, they're as good as each other. You know, just that my grip on the Bulgarian language itself is not that good, so I tend to stick with the English. But I certainly will in future give the Bulgarian actors more of a chance.
Okay, when's your next project there?
Next project, I was due to do a feature there in July regarding as a salsa project. That's still in the throes of the pre-production, so we'll see. But certainly if I don't go there to do a project, I would like to think I'll get back out there at some stage next year with my kids.
Tom Begley, thank you so much for this interview, and I hope to see you soon here.
You will indeed. Thank you very much.
Thank you. От студиото на Bloomberg Фондон, това беше филмовият и театрален режисьор Том Бегли.